back in session now, please. Welcome again. Next, we have a public hearing. We will now open the public hearing on the proposed amendment to Chapter 254 of the Code of St. Mary's County, Maryland, to define agricultural operations. Sign-in sheets were provided out front. If you have not signed in and wish to speak, we ask that you sign in now. We will now have a presentation from our Director of Department of Economic Development, Ms. Chris Casamigos.
Thank you, Commissioner Guy. Thank you, Commissioners. Dr. Bridget, morning. On April 18th, we came before you, and Mr. Jamie Raley did a presentation. Mr. Jamie Raley is the president of the Southern Maryland County Farm Bureau. He brought to our attention a while ago that there was a discrepancy in the definitions of ag operations and agriculture, differed in our right to farm ordinance, differed in our animal control ordinance, and the county zoning code. So Mr. Raley worked with our county attorney, and what's before you today for the public hearing is an amendment to that ordinance to correct those discrepancies. And that's pretty much all I have for today.
Okay. Any questions, Commissioners? Okay, we will now open the hearing for public comments. Mr. James Raley. We ask you to keep your remarks to 3 minutes. The first speaker, you got it.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Commissioners and Dr. Bridget. Jamie Raley, President of St. Mary's County Farm Bureau, 26737 Radio Station Way in Leonardtown. Prior to the 1990s, when the right to farm ordinances first started to become available in the state of Maryland, the only remedy for citizens if they had a complaint about a nuisance operation involving agriculture was to take the farmer to court. That proved to be very expensive and inefficient, so right to farm ordinances were drafted. I believe the first one I found was 1992 for Charles County, and allowing them to create such an ordinance. As time went on in the late 1990s, the state passed a statewide enabling legislation. It's actually in the Maryland courts and judicial proceedings, and it doesn't say right to farm. It addresses nuisance lawsuits pertaining to agricultural operations. There is no right to farm, per se, in the state of Maryland. What these are is good neighbor policies. They're intended to allow mediation of nuisance complaints involving farm operations and educate the public. The reason we're here today is because our current ordinance that we have on the books the definitions were taken verbatim from the state enabling law, so it was very, very dry and didn't contain much information for people. And as Mr. Kalsmus mentioned, when we started looking at other ordinances, we thought it would be better to have uniformity across the board. We could have a good neighbor policy with documents that people could understand and have workable going forward information for people. So Farm Bureau and the County's Ag, Seafood, Forestry Board all took a look at these. We borrowed the definitions from the county zoning ordinance because everybody was satisfied with those and they already existed in an approved ordinance. Applied them where we could to the right to farm ordinance, and we have that document now presented to you for your consideration. This is a public hearing, but do you have any questions for me?
I just want to make sure the Farm Bureau is happy with the current language as it is written today.
Yes, Commissioner, it is. It was a unanimous vote by the Board of Directors of the Farm Bureau to accept that language and submit it on to you for your consideration.
Thank you.
Very good.
Thank you. All right. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you, Mr. Raley. I have no other sign-ups, but if there's anyone else in the audience who would like to speak concerning this issue, you may come forward now. Since no one seems to be moving very quickly, we will now close public hearing for public comments.
I had one quick question for Mr. Castellamus.
Yeah, sure.
I was asked, this was done 18 years ago, what's happened that's made us change it? Was there some lawsuit or something that caused something to happen that impacted somebody?
Commissioner Hewitt, I don't believe there's been any change. I think what happened was Mr. Raley noticed in our animal control ordinance that there was a definition that prompted his attention.
to look at the definitions in the different places and notice there's a difference. So when the animal control ordinance came up, that prompted him to look at the other ones. So that was
okay. So there hasn't been an incident that came up that said this needs to be changed.
This more or less standardizes the definition throughout all of our documents. Is that right, Mr. Reilly?
Yes, Commissioner Guy, but we also did catch an error in the original current county ordinance for forestry operations. It references the state business and occupation section as it pertains to forestry operations. Well, if you read that particular law, down at the bottom it says if the operation generates noise, dust, sight, or other sounds, which are covered under the nuisance issues, the operation is illegal. So the county ordinance shouldn't have applied the business section. It should have applied the forestry section, which is a correction that we made in the ordinance you have before you.
Very good. That's more standard, I think.
So okay. If Mr. Hooper and Gardner's cows are mooing too loud, I can complain about that?
I'd say close the window.
Oh, okay.
Close the windows and turn on the air conditioner, right? Any other questions, Commissioner?
President, guys, one other thing I want to point out. There was some confusion. Some people were in the community were concerned that we were establishing an agriculture reconciliation committee by this amendment. We're not establishing that. That already exists. That hasn't changed at all. So we're not establishing something new.
Okay.
So I want to point that out.
Any other questions, Commissioner? Okay, Commissioner St. Mary's County will receive public comments on this matter for an additional 7 days. Comments should be mailed to the Commissioner of St. Mary's County at P.O. Box 653, Leonardtown, Maryland 20650, or email to csmc@stmarysmaryland.com. We will now close the public hearing. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Thank you all. We'll give it just about a minute here. Okay, we're now going to Commissioner's time. I think we'll start Mr. Hewitt this time.
No,
Commissioner
good.
Hewitt. Well, it's been a great week, great weekend. Wonderful weather, thank God. Got a little hot. First thing I want to talk about is our public forum tonight. Again, it's an opportunity to tell us how you feel about what's going on in our community. And there's many topics out there. So again, I encourage you to come. We need to see you. We want to hear what you have to say. Please come and you're welcome. Secondly, I'd like to talk about Christmas in April. I got involved with a local fraternal organization doing a home this past weekend. And man, it was hot. Now, we did a lot of work and there was a lot of people and at the end of the day, it made me, you know, proud to be an American, proud to be a St. Mary's County citizen. Made you feel good about doing something for people who are in need and people who do need a hand. So to those 700 people who signed up to do that, and all those people that I was there with Saturday morning, people from the Navy, hey, thank you, and it was a great thing. Lastly, it was about 2 years ago, Mr. Larry Walthour brought to my attention the intersection of Great Mills Road and Route 235, i.e. Gate 2. And he said, Mike, you know, when I'm going northbound on 235 and I want to turn left onto Great Mills Road and I'm in the outer lane, I got two lanes, he said, you can have a head-on collision there because people who are going onto the base, going southbound, you meet up with each other. So I said, well, I'll look into it. So I went down there myself, and sure enough, I ran into a person that maybe they were running late for work to get to base or they were in a hurry to get there, but we ended up face to face in that intersection. So he was right, there was a problem. So we brought it to the attention of State Highway. And initially they said, well, let's just cut off one of those turning lanes going northbound and just have one. But they went and studied it and found out that wasn't a good idea. And so they looked at it again and they studied it again and they got whoever involved. And point is, they finally fixed it. They finally changed the curvature of the lane. It's a lot safer. So I want to tell Mr. Walthour, thank you. It's citizens who like him
who look out for other citizens in this county and worry about their safety. And to bring it to my attention and to finally see State Highway fix it, hey, you feel like you've done something. It's a small thing, but that maybe will stop an accident from happening. But it was a good thing. Thank you, Larry Walthour. Thank you, Bill.
So this past week, Commissioner President Guy and I had an opportunity to go to the Choptacon School after hours to see their Academy of Finance kids. I know that our CFO would have been proud. They used the game of Monopoly as an example on how to budget, put together a ledger and budget their books. And a lot of the kids had clean books. It was pretty easy. So I made the suggestion that next year, why don't you use the game of Life? It's a little more challenging. In Monopoly, if you think about it, all you're trying to do is go around the board and knock out all the other players. That's really not how life exists. But in the game of Life, when you spin that dial, you might get another kid, you might get married, you might go to skip college and go right to the workforce. You have to pay taxes. I'd like to see the ledgers on that. But hats off to the kids. They all did a really good job of putting their presentations together, and we had a really good time meeting some of the parents and the kids as they prepare to go to college next year. Thanks.
John?
Christmas in April, Commissioner Hewitt summed it up. It's a great experience for the community. I was able to participate in one of the houses and participated for years, even through my military service until now. So it's always great to be out there and help somebody that's in need and see all the volunteers and how enjoyable they find it. And this just isn't about one day out of the year. This is something that goes on throughout the entire year, the planning, the selection, the fundraising to make it happen. And not everybody's working on the house. Some people are delivering food. Some people are just sitting and speaking with the people that were in their homes doing the repairs for them. So that was a great experience. And then had a chance to attend the Southern Maryland Volunteer Firefighters Association 70th annual banquet that was located in Calvert County this year. Very proud to say that the only board or commissioner board that presented any proclamations or commendations was from St. Mary's County. While Calvert showed up, they said a few kind words, but Charles did not show up, and it was definitely recognized, and the thanks was sent to all of the commissioners from them, and they appreciate everything that we do for them here throughout all of Southern Maryland. So it was a great, great ceremony, lots of life-saving awards, and Senator Miller was there, of course, Calvert, he was there. But he made a very profound statement that I had to back up, which was that when it comes to public safety, there's no D's, there's no R's, and it's all about taking care of the people that take care of our people. And I backed it up in saying that he stood up and he helped us, because what a lot of people didn't realize is in our bonding authority, there was about $2.5 to $3 million set aside to build an advanced life support building, which they're in dire need of. So his help was instrumental in pushing that along to make sure that we're able to take care of our paramedics that go ahead and help save people's lives, and they're going to be able to have more units available and address some of the needs of the community. So I was able to thank him for his help on that as well. And then the only thing I want to discuss beyond that is the multiple emails from the sex ed stuff that's going on, and I'm sure the crowd will be gloriously filled with them tonight, that coming out to tell us how we need to censor everybody and not include or why we may have something to do with some sort of ruling on the sex ed and in the libraries. And the most recent email this morning was talking about pornography filters at the library and how they can be adjusted. And I had to chuckle a little bit, because you have to be able to adjust these filters, because when people are using the computers for research papers, medical journals, various things, these filters actually look at the words, the content, and the photographs that are there. So they're so restrictive that you need to go ahead and say, I need to get to this to be able to view it so I can do this paper. It's not so they're going in and typing in pornography sites and asking it to be dropped so they can sit there and look at porn all day on the library computer. There's a justified need for it. The biggest problem I have with all of this is the conversations I've had with people, and they're afraid about the BDSM, the SM. I've heard everything from ball gags to whips, chains, and all this other stuff. But I turn right around to them and I say, okay, did you and your wife or anybody that's associated with your movement here, go watch 50 Shades of Grey in the movie theater. Did you read the books? I would say 4 out of 5 said yes. So you're going to come to us and say that you don't want a sex ed class that you don't have to attend, you don't have to be a part of, and it's not being funded by public dollars. But you're going to go watch a movie that's all about exactly what you're standing against. So to me, it's very hypocritical, and I have a problem with that. And beyond the fact that I have a problem with censoring the First Amendment, and the other argument that comes along with it is, well, it's obscenities at that point. Well, guess what? If it's obscenities, and it's child pornography, and it's human trafficking, those are key words. None of us up here belong to the St. Mary's County Sheriff's Office. So when it crosses that line, that's where you go, and the state's attorney, not the commissioners of St. Mary's County. So every single argument for this has been flawed, and basically what it comes down to me is one group trying to impress their values upon another group rather than refraining and respecting their rights and other people's rights. So I don't particularly, personally, I wouldn't send my kids to the class if I had kids of that age, but that's my choice. You know, I'd prefer to do it at home and use the other programs that are out there. So either way you look at it, I think there's flawed arguments on both sides, and if people need to respect other people's rights and go from there. And if it moves to criminal, then you go ahead and take it up with the law enforcement authorities. But otherwise, I can't deal with hypocritical arguments. So on that, thank you.
Wow.
Oh, God.
Okay, I'll try to sum this up. We're a little bit deep here, guys. So, anyhow,
that's right.
What would I say? Christmas April, again, was a blast. I was going through, I caught these T-shirts, and I found my 2009, 2008, so, wait, no, ninth, it was the 10th, it was the 9th one or the 8th one. So, anyhow, Christmas April, once again, was a blast. Ken Ritter, you know, you always amuse me out there. I've been doing with Ken and Ms. Blevins for years, and it's a lot of fun. And if you haven't done Christmas April before, you really deserve yourself a chance to go out. And this year I was in Tubman Estates. If you aren't familiar with Tubman Estates, it's down off Chancellor's Run Road. It was one of the original housing projects in the county where we build houses for people to learn to take ownership and take care of them and learn what home appreciation is all about. And a lot of that appreciation goes out to Elmer Brown. So if the Brown family is out there listening, again, I want to say thank you. On the issue on the library, all I would ask is, if you're going to come out, we're here to listen, but I would ask Mr. Sparling, would you please have copies of the Maryland Annotated Code available, starting with chapter and verse on the top, all the way to the bottom, so if people want to come in and read the law before you scream at the commissioners, please look at the law first, and then scream later. That's all I can say, so thank you, and have a great Tuesday.
Oh, that's awesome. That was a good one.
You like that?
Yeah, I do.
Have for me to read.
Thank you, Commissioner.
That's what the libraries are for, you know.
It's
the library,
learn, the law. Learn to read. You may not like what you read, but it'll be educational.
Okay, we'll look forward to the public hearing tonight. Thank you, Commissioners. Along with Commissioner Jarba, it was very interesting to go to Chopticon and see the all the displays and how enthusiastic these students were about their different presentations. Everything, the Monopoly was really probably the fun thing, but like I said, it was quite not realistic as far as the actual life. And but it was good they were able to trace around and do the debits and credits and balance their balance sheets out. And it was pretty, it's very educational. And I'm glad to see they're putting students into this. And I also went to the Envirothon this past week too, with the our Soil Conservation District puts this on, and local high schools put teams together to compete. And what they do is they go from table to table, from plant life to animal life, to they actually excavate out a piece of ground, so they got to identify the various layers of earth, and they go back in the woods, they chop some trees up, and they got to read the rings and give some kind of definition of what the age, think of what type of trees, and it was unbelievable, the enthusiasm. They all had 45 minutes each one of these stations, and then of course they're gathered points and everything, and I'm happy to say again, I don't know why, but Great Mills High School won again. They won last year, and they won again this year.
Team Sasser.
The team won. There's actually two teams, but team won one.
Go did, Hornets.
They did a great job. And I got my another T-shirt, this time a tie-dye green one, you know, from the Envirothon. So I don't wear it out in public too much, but I do wear it around cutting grass. But it's exciting to see young kids like us involved in not only identification of these earth plants, things like that, but, and I kept my mouth shut. I didn't help identify any plants this time. And Mr. Young wouldn't let me talk to him. So anyway, until the end, I didn't talk to him. Also, yesterday I went to this regional area, the VRAC, they call it, the VA Regional Area Council meeting is a tri-county. We're finally moving ahead with our CBOC. The bids are out. They're talking to the contractors. This something's been going on for 14 years. I did remind them about there's probably some satellite, especially down toward Lexington Park, that could be done now. They said they would research that. That was supposed to be after the original CBOC was created. But hopefully he said he's going to move ahead with the secondary one now. So I told him to start contacting these people. Some of them are ready. So with that being said, I appreciate everything. And so let's move on into our...
Can I jump in real quick?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
For those of you who want to read the law before you get here, Maryland Annotated Code, Education, Section 23-401. Because I guarantee you all the commissioners have read it. Not because we wanted to, but because Mr. Spong provided us. And it's enlightening when you read the law. So Maryland Annotated Code, Education, 23-401. So if you don't want to come tonight, read the law.
Yeah, we appreciate it. Yeah, definitely read the law first before you appear tonight. Okay, I need a...
I move to enter into executive session for the purpose of discussing personnel, real property acquisition, and litigation.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Meeting adjourned.